This day I have played a little bit with the quad view method. Here I have two objects, this shoe and here a fusion, and I want to have detailed information about the fusion. So I select this and I say workspace create quad view. And now I have four views. Here the front view. Here the next is the view from the side. Here from up to the left, and here is the view from top. And I can do the same for other objects. So I can say I also can select two objects. We go back to the start. I hide the poles. Here is the cube and the cylinder. These two objects, and now I select both objects and create the next workspace. And in this case, I have these two single objects in the quad view, and I can hide one and can display it again. And I have open all these quad views, so here we see the workspace, and here the quad view for cube and cylinder, and here the quad view for fusion. So if I hide the fusion, then this quad view is empty, and in this view the objects still are displayed. And it's also possible to change the rendering. So I go to the quad view, and here I have the display mode. And if I switch here from false to true, in this case, oh, it was a false. Back, I have to change it here. If I change from false to true, in this case, I have here the display in the layout as it is. In this window I have the render, the shaded display, the second one. Here we have the wireframe, and in the last we have the point model. So I have all four views at the same time, and as seen, we can do this also for the other ones. We have it here for the fusion object, we have it here for the cube and for cylinder, and I can do this more. Let's see, here we have the poles and the map object, so I create for poles workspace. Okay, and I also can create for the map for the grid a quad view. So, and now I can switch between these two views, and all together is this. So I can have a quad views for any object of my document, and I can configure all these views separately. And to configure them, there are some objects here and the object tree.